Into the Spider-Verse. This movie introduces Miles Morales, who's a black Latino Spider-Man from the comics, and he's pretty popular with comic book readers, but otherwise he's pretty much unknown. This movie is his origin story as he becomes the new Spider-Man while interacting with the multiverse and finding out that he's not the only one. I personally really like Miles Morales and his storyline, and I was so excited to finally get to see him on the big screen. To be honest, when the MCU Spider-Man was announced, I was hoping that it would be Miles Morales, but it wasn't. He is technically part of the MCU though, because we do meet his uncle Aaron, played by Donald Glover, in Homecoming. And we also meet him in the incredible PS4 Spider-Man game, though with a different kind of timeline and story and origin. But now he finally has his own movie brought to us by the creative team behind the Lego movies. And just like those movies, they've got themselves another winner here. My God, this movie is good. It's like the ultimate Spider-Man movie. I like it more than Homecoming, and I don't know, maybe after multiple viewings, it might just be my favorite Spider-Man movie ever. The best way to describe this movie is that it's satisfying. I felt so satisfied coming out of this film. It's like, you know, in the holidays when you travel back home to eat your grandmother's holiday dish, whatever it is, and right after you eat it, you get this beautiful, fulfilling, satisfying feeling, and you feel like the world just got a little better for the next 2 hours. That's how this movie made me feel. The script is fantastic. It has a really cool premise, it has really great characters, very nice story, a lot of heart, really good comedy, amazing action, everything. It has everything. The different versions of Spider-Man from the different multiverses are so much fun to watch and absolutely unique to this movie. Spider-Man Noir, voiced by Nicolas Cage, is an absolute highlight. Every single line that this character says cracked me up. I absolutely love him. All the characters and heroes were really good. Miles Morales is fantastic. This is a great outing for him. I can't wait to see him in other things. I thought Peter Parker was really good in this, voiced by the guy from New Girl. The two of them had a really nice relationship and dynamic. The best relationship in the movie is actually between Miles Morales and his father, which is a really cool relationship that has been portrayed really well and adapted very well from the comics. And it's like one of my favorite things about Miles Morales is his relationship with his cop father, which is, by the way, a missed opportunity in Spider-Man PS4. Spider-Gwen is here! Hello, Spider-Gwen! Awesome! I loved her. I loved all of them. I love Peter Parker. I love Penny Parker. I can't believe these characters actually exist, but look it up. All of them exist in the Spider-Man comics, and they're here, and they're absurd and absolutely fantastic. I also really enjoyed the structure of the movie. It takes Miles Morales a while before he actually becomes Spider-Man, and for the first time, I think, maybe ever in a Spider-Man movie, I really felt that wearing the mask was earned by this character, and I was very excited to see him become Spider-Man. Also worth mentioning, the soundtrack of this movie is unbelievable. It's so good. I think it might be my favorite soundtrack of the year. But the most striking thing about Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse is the animation. This movie is made in a certain style that makes it look like it's a comic book come to life. And it's absolutely breathtaking. Visually, this movie is striking. It's beautiful, worth checking out in Dolby Cinema or in IMAX. Worth the ticket, 100%. And it gives you a very unique experience for the Spider-Man world. I don't think the story could have been told in any other way. It's definitely served by the fact that it's animated, and I felt like the filmmakers really made use of that fact. Which also opens up the opportunity for more crazy Spider-Man storylines that can't be told in a live-action format and would fit this format very well. So really, at this point, the sky's the limit. If there's one thing, one tiny thing that maybe didn't work for me much in this movie, it's probably Wilson Fisk. I thought that his design was really cool, but as a character, I felt like he was meh, and as a villain, especially because I've been pampered and I'm used to Wilson Fisk from Netflix's Daredevil. R.I.P. Netflix's Daredevil, by the way.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Otherwise, for me, I almost had the perfect experience with Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. What do you want? It introduces you to really cool Spider-Man characters, it gives you a fantastic, fantastic origin story for a great character that finally deserves some screen time, it's beautiful action, a lot of heart, it will make you emotional, it will make you laugh a lot, it will make you tap your feet to the beautiful soundtrack. It's an insane experience. If you're not a fan of Spider-Man or you're not that much into it, you will enjoy it, but if you're a fan of Spider-Man, Spider-Man, this is the ultimate Spider-Man film. You have to check it out, and I'm gonna give Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse a 9.5 out of 10. So, have you seen Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse? What did you think about it? Is there any Spider-Man weird character that you'd like to see in an animated format? Let me know in the comment section. And as always, like, share, and subscribe, but don't forget to ask me what you'd like me to review for you next. See ya!